Do you want some mega wow? Do you want some mega wow? Do you want some mega wow? Today,
I'm your host, Katie Nguyen, and our special guest is Alba. This is my friend's cat, Betty, who shoots lasers out of her eyes. Just kidding. Betty's a real cat. But those are cartoon lasers, and the sound was just me hitting the spring toy.
What?
I learned that trick from sound engineers. Their job is to make the sounds that you hear in movies. So I've got this metal spring toy just hanging here, and let's see what different sounds we can make with it. I can flick it with my finger. I can flick it with something else made of metal. And now I'm gonna add the styrofoam cup to the spring toy. What do you think will happen?
What do you think will happen?
The cup acts as an amplifier, which makes the sound louder. Pretty cool. So why am I making sound effects? Well, I made a short movie about looking for a lost guinea pig. And adding sound effects is an important part of making movies. What other amazing sounds can you make or engineer using things around the house? Let's find out. Alba?
Hi, Katie.
Good to see you. How are you doing today?
Good.
I want to make some sound effects for a short movie that I made. And I understand that you know about making sound effects for a video game that you made. Can you tell me about your video game?
So, you're a carrot and you're trying not to get eaten by rabbits. Yeah, you can play it and then you use the arrow keys on your keyboard to make it go forwards, backwards, left, and right.
How did you make your game?
I used Scratch. It's like a programming website for kids. In my school in kindergarten, one time I did like a coding class and it taught you how to use Scratch.
Cool, okay, so you had some experience in school and then you just took it home and just went off with it. That's fantastic. So how did you make sound effects for your game?
So we have our garage door opener, and on the back of it, there's like this thing so you can attach it to your pants, and but when you like push it down and let go, like this way, then it makes a boing sound.
Okay, cool. Would you help me make some sound effects for my movie?
Yes.
Excellent. Oh, I'm so excited for this.
Let's start making sound effects.
So we'll check back in with Alba in just a moment. But first, I need to walk down the hall. When movies are made, a lot of times sound effects are added later. Sound engineers choose which sounds to add to movies or video games, like Alba's. If you want your footsteps to sound like ducks, you can. Or you can make them sound like footsteps. So how do you make the sound of footsteps? Well, I've got a floor tile here and a pair of shoes. I'm gonna watch the video to try to match up the sounds with what I see. I'm recording with this microphone here so we can put the sounds on the computer and match the footstep sounds with the video. Now for my movie. I wanna make a sound effect for this scene where rain is hitting my umbrella. So I'm gonna try some things. I have a couple different surface materials. I have a metal cookie sheet, and I have a tarp. And I also have a bowl of sand and a bowl of rice. And I'm gonna experiment and play around with these to see which combination of these things sound the most like rain falling on an umbrella.
Dropping sand.
Kind of sounds like when rain hits the roof to me. Let me know what you think if it sounds like rain on an umbrella to you. Yeah, the metal cookie sheet doesn't sound as much like an umbrella to me, even though it does sound like rain. But in the scene in my movie, it's definitely just hitting the umbrella. I think I know which one I like best for the movie. Which one do you think sounds most like rain hitting an umbrella?
Sand on a cookie sheet? Sand on a tarp? Rice on a cookie sheet? Or rice on a tarp? Now, back to Alba.
So Alba, you've got two trays in front of you, one with cornflakes, one with potato chips, and I want you to play with them and let me know which one, in your opinion, sounds more like walking through dry leaves. Sound like dried leaf to you? Gotta get a good listen to it. Let's try the potato chips and see if they sound any different or if they sound more or less like dried leaves. So we've used our hands. Do you have anything else there that you can use to make dry leaf sounds with the cereal or the chips? Oh, okay, okay. Interesting, stepping in dry leaves.
I think the shoes and the potato chips sounds the most like it.
That's really cool. So sometimes sound engineers have to experiment a lot with different materials.
I like this sound.
I like the sound too. Don't eat them afterward, but sounds delicious and crunchy. So you've also got some notebooks and some hats. And again, I want you to play with those and let me know which one, in your opinion, sounds more like crows flapping their wings. Oh, you're flipping it. Okay, yeah, try everything. Does that sound kind of like flapping wings to you?
I'm gonna
try the hat. Oh, that sounds pretty good. I wanna try that too.
Oh yeah, I like that. Maybe if I put two hats together, like two wings.
Two hats, oh, that's a good idea. Do you think the two hats sounds more like bird wing flapping than one hat?
Yeah.
Yeah, kinda does. That's a really good point because it's two wings flapping, so two things are making noise. So in your opinion, Alba, between one hat, Two hats. You think the two hats is the most sounds most like bird flapping? I think so too. That sounds really good. Let's do it again. If I close my eyes, it's like I'm surrounded by birds. Alba, that was so great. I'm so impressed by your sound effects. I just, you know, what do I want to say? What do I want to say? Oh, I know. And now, The Lost Guinea Pig, with sound effects by Alba and Katie. Lost Guinea Pig, named Laser. Don't worry, I'll find you, little buddy. I think I found your guinea pig named Laser. How do I know it's him? Never mind, it's him. Thanks for watching. What fun sound effects can you make at home?
This is Bro Studios.